Welcome back, everyone. Comedy Central named him one of the top 100 stand-up comedians of all time. And now he's returning to Las Vegas after a few years. I'm talking about the very funny Bobby Slayton, who joins me now in studio.
Actually, that was a lie, the top 100. I'm the top 10 of all time. You know, when they did that list, it's actually a while ago, and there's so many comedians that are great since then. I'd be surprised if I made the top 150, not because I'm not good, but there's just so many comics and so many things going on, so many Netflix specials and so many comedy clubs.
Right.
And speaking of that, I am downtown at the, you know, just started doing stand-up is, they started doing it at the Plaza. They have the comedy club called the Comedy Works, and what's really cool about it is it's kind of one of these retro, old-school, rat-packy kind of nightclubs. It's big, but not too big like the Wynn Theater. It's bigger than a comedy club. It's got booths. It's just kind of that old-school, classic kind of vibe, like me.
Yes, of
course.
Well, how long has it been since you, is it 2 years since you performed in Vegas?
I was here a couple of years ago. I did a show, Bobby Slayton and Friends at the South Point. And I had my own room here years ago at Hooters Casino, which actually went okay, but nobody was really going to Hooters, you know. It was on this, it's now, they've just changed their name, but it was originally San Remo, then Hooters. But it was like, you know, you had all these crack prostitutes and bums between the Tropicana to get to Hooters, and broken glass. I don't think people, they had to make it a destination, you know. But I started getting people there because nobody wanted to go to the Strip because the Strip became crazy.
Right.
And it's the same way, I don't want to scare people from downtown, but you know what it's like downtown. On the weekends, it's crazy and it's nuts. And you walk into the Plaza and you go to the showroom and you feel like you're out of that, you know, it's a little bit of civility. Oscar Steakhouse, it feels like old Vegas. It's kind of
cool. We've revitalized downtown. It's been a while, Bobby, since you've been here. It's nuts. It's much nicer.
It's getting nicer.
It is.
And you know, it's interesting. So you know, I haven't been down there in years, and I'm down there, and I'm walking around last night, and it's right by the bus station, so, you know, you have the transients and the homeless and the drunks, and I go up to the Strip to see a friend of mine at the Wynn, and the Strip really is not that much better. You still get the homeless people, you still get the bums, but then you get those idiots dressed up like Spider-Man, you know, in bed with body odor, who try to take a picture with you. I'd rather be downtown. There's none of those cartoon characters.
They do have some body odor. I never really thought of that. Picking up on things.
It was Batman particularly. Spider-Man smelled okay, and Minnie Mouse, there were three of them, they smelled delicious, but it was a Batman that didn't smell good.
Steer clear of Batman.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, in addition to stand-up, you've also been in a bunch of movies. We've got Bandits, Get Shorty, and your voice has been on Family Guy. Your voice is so recognizable. When people come up to you and recognize you, what is the one thing they're like, oh, I loved you in?
You know what? I was at Oscar Steakhouse the other night. And, you know, people always say, because I've been in a lot of movies, but a lot of really small parts. Like Bandits, you probably never saw. Nobody saw Bandits. Came out 18 years ago. It came out the week of 9/11, so the country is a little preoccupied with that. But it was Barry Levinson, who did so many great movies. It was Billy Bob Thornton, Bruce Willis, Cate Blanchett, and then me, and nobody saw the movie. It was really fun. But Dreamgirls, so I'm in Oscars last night, and one of the waitstaff comes over. You know, I know you're from somewhere. I said, well, I'm playing in the comedy club downstairs at Comedy Works. I'm a comic. He goes, no, I know you're from something else. And you don't want to be an idiot, you know, but I don't want to sit there through my whole resume of what I've been in.
Right.
You know? So I said, well, maybe I've been in some movies. He goes, no, I know your voice from something. I know your voice.
Yeah.
So the guy keeps coming back to the table. And I said, he goes, have you done any cartoons? I said, yeah, I did like Family Guy, a few others. He said, no, I've never seen Family Guy. The guy wouldn't leave me alone. And finally he came up to me. And he said, did you do a radio commercial for Skechers that play? I did one especially for Vegas a couple of years ago, and he remembered my voice because it's such a pretty, romantic, mellifluous tones of Bobby Slayton.
Mellifluous.
It's such a romantic, nice voice. I'm surprised I don't have JC's job.
You can do it.
He said you can do
Anybody
it.
Anybody can do it.
It's not hard.
But I don't want to talk to him.
No, it's such a recognizable voice, and I just thank you so much for coming in. We hope you come back before two more years go by.
I hope so, too.
We'll see you. We'll see you back here.
Can I make a reservation to talk to Lindsay and not JC? Can I put that in the books now?
I can pencil you in.
That's usually how it goes. Absolutely. I would do the same.
Right,
I would do the same.
I'll come back.
Bobby, thank you much for coming in. Check him out tonight and tomorrow over at the Comedy Works inside the Plaza Hotel and Casino. JC.